Hi, I'm Jen Kleiner, coming to you live from AFI Fest. I'm a writer-director, and you can learn more about my work at jenkleiner.com. In the meantime, we're coming to you live with Kirk Kelly from The Actors Reporter and Live Video Inc. Thanks so much.
I'm Kirk Kelly from Actors Reporter and Live Video Inc. at AFI. How many years have they been doing this, Jen?
Wow, you really got me there.
And I don't know either. So I think 25 years?
Well, yeah.
Since the 1800s.
The festival or the AFI, the organization?
The festival.
The festival? I feel like about 20 years.
Okay. Fabulous.
Yeah.
So, Jen, what brings you to AFI Fest this year?
I am an AFI grad.
Really?
Yes.
What year? What class?
I was a directing fellow. I got my master's.
A directing fellow. You look like a directing female.
Do I?
Is it called fellow?
Yes.
I see.
A directing fellow.
I've learned something new today. Looks like a lady. Yeah, so you're a directing fellow.
Graduated in 2007.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So is it true that most of the alumni of AFI, by the time they get there, are not necessarily 18 to 24?
No, not at all. I had classmates that were in their 40s. I had a classmate who was in his 50s. It's all age. Actually, I feel like majority of my classmates were over 25, and the ones that were under had a more difficult time. I think having more life experience before you start such a rigorous program is a good thing.
So you wouldn't necessarily recommend coming out of high school and jumping right into AFI?
Absolutely not.
Why?
Well, before I went to AFI, I did 4 years of undergrad film school at UC Santa Cruz. And then I did
good
four
school.
Years. It's a great school.
That's what I said.
Big slug supporter.
Yes.
And then I came down and I worked in development and production for 4 years. So I really had a taste of the industry before I had decided to zero in on directing.
How long is the AFI experience?
2.5 years.
Okay, so you went there to learn how to direct through the AFI schools. Do people, when they go there, for those who haven't attended, specialize in certain areas like, I want to go to AFI to learn how to produce, or I want to direct, or light?
Well, what's great about AFI is that it's a conservatory, so you get into a certain discipline as opposed to the school in general. So when you get in, you're either applying for the screenwriting program, the producing program, the directing program, cinematography, editing, production design. You're not competing with everybody to try and get into one track at the end to make your own film, such as other graduate programs like USC or UCLA. So I really appreciated getting into graduate school with a title already defined, so I could live for 2.5 years in that role, relating to people and collaborating from that experience, rather than having to prove that I deserve to be that.
There are a lot of professional mentors who help the people who are going to AFI Conservatory, whether it's actors from After SAG, seasoned producers, directors. Who are some of the notable people who influenced you when you were studying there?
Wow, there are so many. I often think
all right, your top 100.
While I was studying at AFI, there were many incredible guests. I often think about the time when David Lynch was there, smoking on stage, talking about transcendental meditation and his time at AFI. I also loved when Sofia Coppola came with Marie Antoinette, which I know was a controversial film for her, but I loved it, and it meant a lot to me to be there. We had incredible exchanges with amazing filmmakers while I was studying AFI. They continue to have amazing programming.
What have you done since your time at AFI?
I have been doing a lot of different things. I have a coaching and consulting practice called Intuitive Artists, where I work with a lot of writers, directors, actors, and producers, helping them to realize their potential and actualize their creative endeavors.
Mm-hmm.
And I also write and direct. I have a lot of projects in development, and I was hired to direct a documentary feature this year, so I'm in development on that. And I'm also a part-time celebrity stylist, so
really?
I work with Guy Pearce and his wife, and I enjoy styling them for the red carpet whenever they have an appearance.
So what projects are you working on?
Let's see, what am I allowed to talk about?
Oh, you signed the non-disclosure too.
No.
Yes.
I have a couple of great pilots.
Really? So you're flying now.
I'm flying, yep.
Yes.
Uh-huh. You're hilarious.
Thank you. It beats being funny looking. So, pilots for television.
Yeah.
Yes. And?
Okay, one is called The Other Mothers. Wow, that was a good luck sign, wasn't it?
Yeah. And it
if
happened right on cue.
If you guys didn't hear that glass broke at the moment I said the name of the show. The Other Mothers, ladies and gentlemen. It's about three single moms who have to do whatever they can in order to live in the right zip code to send their kids to enchantment elementary school.
That's so real. That actually happens a lot.
Yeah. And ours is set in the Hollywood Hills. It's based on a little school called Wonderland.
How cool.
Yeah.
And your other one?
The other one is a show called We're 30 Now. And that one I did not write. The Other Mothers I wrote with Susie Hardy.
Okay.
And she's also a stylist.
So this will be about stylist soccer moms.
No, actually, it's not about styling at all. I wrote another show about styling. It's called Off the Cuff.
I see.
And that's about the background world of celebrity styling and
PR. Oh, how cool.
In a fictional tale.
The behind the scenes of hair. So, in any future films you're working on right now?
Yes. I wrote a film called One Big Happy Family.
Yes.
It's a dysfunctional family rom-com that I'm trying to make.
Okay.
And it's about, you know, a relationship expert who writes a book on how to not have the marriage that your parents had, except she's not married. So when she's about to go on tour to publicize it,
she's a real authority,
right,
too.
Totally.
Yes. She hasn't a clue, but we love her.
Right. Her publicist recommends that she marry her boyfriend, so she proposes. And when she brings him home to meet her hippie family, full of divorced therapists and their, you know, ex and new partners, things get shooken up. And she has to learn the new meaning of love and relationships. All that good stuff.
Fabulous. Truly a pleasure to have time with you. I look forward to coming to sweat with you someday. I'm Kurt Kelly. We'll be back with more from AFI in just a moment.